Hi, I'm Paige Turner, world-famous storyologist. A storyologist is someone who travels the world, going on adventures, collecting, telling, and writing stories. So I love being here at a school library media center.
And I'm Kenny. I used to be a clown with the circus. But I ran away from the circus and joined Paige Turner as a storyologist in training.
I'm sure most of you know the FCAT is coming up, and sometimes kids, parents, and even teachers can get a little stressed out this time of the year.
But that's okay, that's why we're here. You see, we're going to give you a bunch of tips and tricks that will help you score higher on the FCAT, reduce stress, and maybe even have a little fun.
A few years ago, we created a series of short videos called This Is Only a Test. Play them on the morning announcements to help kids taking the FCAT get higher scores and have less stress.
And you know what? People seem to dig them so much that we thought maybe the entire world would like them too. So we decided to take all of those little videos and put them on 4 half-hour specials and broadcast them on TV all over the world.
Yeah. Anyway, this is one of those half-hour specials.
So hopefully, after you watch this show, you'll be completely without stress, you'll be having a lot of fun, and you'll be totally...
relaxed.
Oh, the test? That you'll take. You have brains in your head and clothes on the rest, and I'm sure you can do very well in this test, for all you've been taught and all that you've read is sitting there patiently right in your head. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 99.75% guaranteed. Today is your day, so just do your best and always remember, this is only a test. What's the matter?
That's Flash, Paige Turner's personal assistant. He's a little strange.
Not any stranger than a C-L-O-W-N clown.
Flash, what's wrong?
Well, I'm studying for this big test coming up, but these guys, I can't think when...
Flash, what are you talking about?
Follow me. Let me introduce you to my study group.
FCAT.
And I'm studying for a different FCAT. The Funny Clown Achievement Test.
Well, in that case, maybe you guys should watch this. What are you doing?
Oh, I'm studying my storyologist handbook so I can become an official storyologist, not just a storyologist in training. But for some reason, I'm finding it very difficult to concentrate.
Kenny, this is not the way to study. Kenny, this is not the way to study.
I can't hear you. I'm listening to the radio and watching TV.
That's better. Kenny, it's not a good idea to study with the TV and radio blasting. You can't concentrate. You need to work in a quiet place with good lighting. A neat desk helps too.
Hey, how are you doing that snap thing?
You need to find a special place and time where you can sit down quietly and concentrate each day.
No, seriously, I mean, how are you doing that snap thing? I mean, come on!
Oh, that? That's easy.
What? Paige? No, I can't study in the dark, Paige. Oh, look, there's that jelly donut.
Okay, guys, let's get to work. Tyler, what are you working on?
I'm trying to memorize my vocabulary words, but it's really hard.
Wait, I have an invention that will help. A while ago, I came up with this brilliant idea where you write things on cards and...
Boy, this is brilliant! I completely amazed myself. I am brilliant, and I'm gonna make $1 million! Ha 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 ha!
Hi, Flash, what's up?
What's up? What's up? I have come up with the most brilliant idea.
What is it?
Well, you know how I have to study all this vocabulary for the rats, right?
Yeah.
And it's completely stressing me out.
Oh, Flash.
I stare at the page, and the words just sort of stare back at me.
They stare at you, huh?
They stare. Like this! Anyway, here's what I did. I took these little index cards, and I wrote the words on one side, and I wrote the definition, you know, what the word means, on the other.
Okay.
Okay, so here's the great part. Oh, this is good. Take the card, hold up the word, and I'll read it.
Okay, the word is consonant.
Consonant. A consonant is a letter of the alphabet that isn't a vowel.
That's right.
Okay, do another. Grab another card.
Okay, let's see. Alliteration.
Don't tell me. I know it's the use of a series of words that start with the same letter, like Fantastic Flash flourishes fabulously, or Marvelous Mouse is a master!
That's great, Flash!
These things are great. Studying is actually fun. It's like a game. So I'm gonna package them and sell them, and I'm gonna make a fortune.
Flash.
Here's the best part, the name. I'm gonna call them Flashcards. Get it? Flashcards, because my name is Flash and I invented them!
Flash, you didn't invent flashcards.
What?
They've been around for years.
You've gotta be kidding me.
Nope. It's okay, though. Flashcards are an excellent way to study for a test.
I'm not gonna make $1 million?
Sorry.
Oh, they do have a great name, though. Flashcards!
Brilliant, Flash. What are you working on?
Well, I keep reading this passage over and over, but I don't understand what's happening in it. I just can't picture it in my mind.
Well, I know how to fix that.
Hey, Paige, you want to go see a movie?
Oh, no thanks. I'm reading a great book. It's just like watching a movie.
Well, no, it's not. I mean, movies have heroes, villains, action, adventure, romance.
Books have all of those things, too.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's true. But, you know, you can actually see a movie on the screen. When you're looking at a book, all you see are the words on the page.
Well, that's not true. When I read, it's like seeing a movie in my mind.
Okay. You've been in the lighthouse too long. Come on.
No, Kenny. When I read a book, I don't just see words on a page. I actually picture it in my mind. It's just like watching a movie. Come on, you try it. Read this old folk tale.
Once upon a time, the sun and the wind had an argument about who was stronger. They argued, they saw a man wearing a cape walking down the road. They decided to hold the contest. Whichever one of them could make the man take his cape off would be the winner. Win, try first.
Kenny, you're not even paying attention to the story.
They're just words on a page, Paige.
Do you even know what the story was about?
Yeah, something about the wind and the sun and the fruitcake.
Okay, Kenny, try it again. Come on. But this time, I want you to picture what you're reading. Don't just read words on the page.
Once upon a time, the sun and the wind had an argument about who was stronger. They saw a man wearing a cape walk down the road and decided to hold a contest. Whichever one of them could make the man take his cape off first would be the winner. Wind blew fiercely, trying to blow the cape off. But the man just held the cape tighter. Then it was sun's turn. The sun shone on the man and he began to feel warm. It got hotter and hotter, and at last, the man took his cape off. The sun smiled at her brother the wind and said, "My gentle warmth was able to accomplish what all your fierce winds could not." Wow, you're right. That was a great movie. Well, I mean story. But we're still missing one thing.
What's that?
Popcorn.
Hey, maybe you guys can help me out with something. I'm looking for a synonym for the word funny, but I don't know where to look.
Sheesh, don't you guys watch your own videos?
Of course we do.
All the time.
We're fantastic.
We love it.
Well, then you should remember this one.
Man, how am I supposed to find this stuff?
What's the matter, Kenny?
Oh, well, I got a message in a bottle from a junior storyologist. He wants my help.
Then what's the problem?
Well, I have no idea how to help this guy.
Well, why don't you read me the letter, and maybe I can help you help him.
All right, here we go. It says, "Dear Kenny, I'm writing a story about kangaroos because I think they're the coolest animals in the world." Oh, actually, they are pretty cool. I mean, they got the pouches. They could, like, put a sandwich in there or something. Oh, yeah. Sorry. "I'd like to learn more about kangaroos before I write this story." Oh, that's a good idea. Well, you always gotta learn more about a subject before you just start writing about it. I mean, you couldn't just start willy-nilly, you know what I'm saying?
Can you get back to the letter, please?
I'm on it. "I went to the library, but all the kangaroo books were taken out. Where else can I find out some general information about kangaroos, like what country they come from and where it is? And, oh yeah, what's the meaning of the word marsupial? I hope you can help me. Sincerely, Alex Yates, Junior Storyologist." So there you go, dude. He's looking for some general information about kangaroos, what country they come from, and what the meaning of marsupial is.
That's no problem, man. There are three books that can help you.
I've been all the way up and down through this place, and there's no books about kangaroos. Zilp, zilzo, nada, nothing. The big old goose egg.
Look at the bookshelf right over there.
No. I think you got your files mixed up. These are encyclopedias.
Kenny, encyclopedias have all sorts of information. They may not have as much information as a book on kangaroos would have, but they are a great place to start.
Well, which one do I start with? There's like 20 of them here.
They're in alphabetical order. What does kangaroo start with?
K. Oh, just like Kenny.
So look for the book with the K words in it.
Okay. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. Okay. Here we go. All right, let's see. Oh. Kangaroo, here it is. Oh, there's a lot of information here. It says they come from a country called Australia and that they're marsupials. Hey, there's that word marsupial again. How do I find out what that means?
You need another book, the dictionary. It's right over there.
What's the difference between a dictionary and an encyclopedia?
A dictionary just has the meaning of words, but it's also in alphabetical order. What does marsupial start with?
M, just like Kenny. Hold on. Marsupial is an animal that carries its young in a pouch.
Very good.
But we still need to find out where their country is. Now, the encyclopedia said they come from a country called Australia. Where the heck is that?
Well, you need another book. It's an atlas. It's right there. Oh. An atlas has different kinds of maps, as well as facts about different countries.
Wow, it's like on the other side of the world.
Now you can answer all the questions that junior storyologist asked you.
Nah, I don't think so.
Why not?
Because I'm gonna tell him where he can find the answers himself. Hey, an encyclopedia gives you general information about a bunch of things, and it's in alphabetical order. A dictionary gives you the meaning or definition of a word, and it's also in alphabetical order. An atlas has maps of countries, cities, towns, anything you need.
Very good.
Now, here's another important book.
What's that?
Phone book. After all this hard work, I'm gonna order a pizza. You in? Yeah, hook me up.
Hey guys, has anyone seen the dictionary?
Maybe. Why? What do you need it for?
There's a word in the paragraph that I don't understand. So I need the dictionary.
Well, I'm sitting on it. Hey, what do you want? I'm short. Try to use clues, kid.
Clues?
Yeah, clues in the sentence to help you figure it out.
Oh, no. Oh.
Flash, what's the matter?
Message bottles just came, and I got a postcard from Paige.
Well, that's wonderful. How is she?
I'm not quite sure. There's some words that I just don't understand, and I can't find the dictionary.
Well, maybe we can figure them out.
Figure them out? How?
Clues.
Clues?
Sure. Clues in the sentence might help us understand the meaning of the words.
Well, I circled all the words that I didn't understand.
Well, that's excellent. Let's see. Dear Flash, Kenny and I found a treasure map. We were so ecstatic.
Ecstatic. That word right there. What does it mean?
Well, what do you think it means?
I think it means, really sad.
All right. One way to determine if we've chosen the right word is to substitute it in the sentence. We were so sad, we jumped for joy. Does it sound like they're sad?
No. Jump for joy, it sounds like a clue.
Yes.
If they jump for joy, then ecstatic means they're really happy.
That's it. Excellent. Let's move on. We dug in the sand and discovered a piggy bank filled with currency. You know what currency is, Flash?
I know. It's a kind of pickle.
No.
Oatmeal!
No.
I know. A swarm of bees!
Oh, Flash, it's a piggy bank. What do you normally find in a piggy bank?
Money?
That's it! Huh. Currency is another word for money. Then, Kenny realized he buried the bank years ago. Boy, did he feel ludicrous!
I know this one. He must have felt ridiculous.
That's it. Love, Paige Turner.
Thanks for helping me figure out the words, Professor. Now I don't feel ludicrous.
Oh, Flash.
Excuse me.
You mean me?
Yes. I'm here from a local TV station, and I'm going to give you a big prize if you can tell me the meaning of the word conclusion.
You want me to tell you what conclusion means?
Yes. The meaning of the word conclusion.
Why?
I'm sorry, I lied. I'm not really from a TV station. Go on! Get out of here!
Oh, and I thought this was my big break.
I'm sorry. I just really wanted to know what the word conclusion meant, and I didn't think you would tell me unless I was important enough to work at a TV station.
Oh, no, not at all. I'd love to tell you the meaning of the word conclusion.
You would?
Of course. Now, let's see. A conclusion is simply an educated guess about the outcome of a certain situation.
Nope. Sorry. Didn't get a word of that one.
Look, here I am standing by a bus sign. Can you conclude what might be driving by here soon?
An octopus?
No.
Oh, I have it. Oh, I know this one. Oh, this is so easy.
Yes?
A turtle?
No, a bus.
Oh, a bus. Oh, I knew that.
So that is all that a conclusion is. An educated guess based on the facts.
So, I could conclude that you are on your way somewhere now.
Very good. Hello, could you excuse me? Can I move over?
Goodbye! And thank you for sharing your knowledge with me. Oh, I didn't see that one coming.
What are you eating?
A muffin. It's not very good though. I think I added too much cauliflower.
Kenny? I think it's supposed to be flour, not cauliflower.
Oh, that explains a lot.
Did you read the directions?
Directions, right! No.
Hello there, Professor Pulsar here with today's project. I've made a model airplane. I know it doesn't look like much, but I think it's going to fly. Perhaps it could be a hat instead. Or a doorstop. Maybe it's a hairball from a styrofoam cat. All right, I know why it doesn't look good. I didn't follow directions. I thought, oh, Professor Pulsar doesn't need directions. Well, Professor Pulsar needs directions. But let's try it again. Only this time, I'm going to follow the directions. I'm finished, and it looks perfect, all because I followed the directions. Now I can race Paige Turner in her hot air balloon. Well, everyone fasten your seatbelts and keep your tray tables in the upright and locked position.
One of the most important directions to follow is to fill in the bubbles.
While flying through the sky one lovely spring day, Bubble Boy saw a kid taking a test.
Oh no! That kid isn't filling in the bubbles all the way!
So Bubble Boy, along with his trusty sidekick number two, swooped out of the sky to right the wrong.
Stop! It is I, Bubble Boy, and my trusty sidekick number two. I see you're taking a computerized test.
Yeah.
Well, I see you've only made check marks in the bubbles.
So?
Those tests are graded by a computer. So, you have to fill the bubbles in all the way or the computer will mark it wrong.
That blows.
Yes. Yes, it does. Here! You can borrow number two, my trusty sidekick, to fill the bubbles in all the way.
I made a mistake.
That's all right, my loyal follower. Just go ahead and erase it. But make sure you erase it all the way.
Thanks, Bubble Boy.
No problem, kid. Now, give me back my pencil. Here are Bubble Boy's rules for computerized tests.
Number one.
Make sure you fill in the bubbles all the way with a number two pencil.
Number two.
Hey, if you make a mistake, just erase it all the way.
Number three.
Well, really, there's just only two rules.
This has been another test saved by the bubble-headed boy and his sidekick, number two.
No, that's Bubble Boy.
That's what I said.
No, you said bubble-headed boy.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Didn't.
Dead.
Well, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. I hope you had fun. Do your best. Don't stress. And always remember,
this is only a test.